All right, good afternoon, folks. Let me introduce the other folks I have with me here this afternoon. To my left, I've got Assistant City Manager Heath Lloyd. And then to my right, I've got Assistant Chief Lenny Gunther. I want to let everybody know that I've also been in constant contact with the city manager and the mayor. Let me start by giving you a brief overview of the incident that occurred last night. Last night, officers responded to the 200 block of Avery Street about 9 o'clock on a report of a shooting. Officers discovered several victims at the scene. We also were advised that we had other victims who arrived at the hospital, Memorial Hospital, via private personal vehicle. In total, and let me clarify some of the numbers that you may have received last night, in total we had 8 victims, ranging from the ages of 33 to 1. Actually, the one-year-old is actually 18 months old, so we did not have an actual two-year-old. Most of the victims, including the one-year-old, were either grazed or received non-life-threatening injuries. We had one of the victims, a 20-year-old male, who died as a result of his injuries. We have, in addition to that, 2 other victims who are listed in critical condition at the hospital. Like I said, the injuries to the other victims are listed as non-life-threatening injuries. This incident involved at least 3 apartments and 6 vehicles that received damage as a result of the gunfire. In addition to that, we recovered at least 60 shell casings at the scene. We're hearing that this incident may, and I stress the word may, be a result of a conflict between 2 groups. We're still checking on that information. As far as information that we can pass on to the public right now, what we have, very preliminary information, is we, right before the shooting occurred, we had a dark color or possibly a red sedan that was seen fleeing the area. The officers, actually the detectives, are still attempting, they attempted to interview the victims last night at the hospital, but the hospital scene was pretty chaotic last night. So they're actually going back out today to conduct follow-up interviews with the victims in hopes of obtaining some additional information. We believe the incident last night also may be related to an incident that occurred at the same location last week on Tuesday night. The same residents was damaged by 10 gunshot rounds last Tuesday night. Now, here's a very disturbing kind of situation with that particular incident. We could not find any witnesses, and no one would provide us with any information regarding that particular incident. We were out there on Tuesday night. No one would talk to us. We went back out on Wednesday, sent detectives out in plain clothes. Still, nobody would provide any information to us. 2 days later, we end up with a mass shooting at the same location. What I can tell you is we continue to see these incidents of gun violence occur in our community, folks. This cannot and should not continue to happen in our community. These senseless acts of gun violence in our community have to stop. We continue to encourage members of our community to come forward. We certainly would hope that they would come forward during this particular situation and provide us with any information they have, because we certainly don't want this situation to repeat itself in any other areas. There are many ways for individuals to contact us. If they have any information that they want to provide to us regarding last night's incident or the previous incident, of course they can call our crime tip line at 912-525-3124. That's 912-525-3124. They also can contact our homicide unit. That's 912-651-4362. 912-651-4362. Or they can contact Crime Stoppers and remain anonymous. That's 912-234-2020. 912-234-2020. If they don't want to contact us, if they don't want to contact the police department. I think the mayor's made it very clear that they can contact the mayor, and he will get that information to us. They can contact their alderman, who was at the scene, any other elected officials, or they can actually contact their community of faith members. I want to really stress that we can stop this. And when I say we, I mean the Savannah Police Department, also in partnership with members of our community, but we have to work together. I would ask if for no other reason individuals come forward with information, if for no other reason, for the sake of that one-year-old child that was injured last night. I also want to take the opportunity to thank our local, state, and federal partners. Some of them were with us last night and assisted us with this incident, and several of them have followed up with us today and offered assistance for whatever we need to assist with addressing the incident and actually seeing what we can do to identify the suspects involved in this incident. So that's what I have right now as far as an overview of the incident. I will entertain a few questions that I may or may not be able to answer at this time.
Just confirming, Chief, that you got a call around 9 p.m. last night?
That's correct.
When you say that this was between two groups, are we talking gang-related violence, or is that still kind of up in the air?
That's preliminary information, and we're still checking on that. That's just something we heard at the scene, but we're still checking on that. Well, we still have our gang unit. Our gang unit was on scene last night. Our gang unit was actively involved in the investigation last night, as well as other members of our criminal investigation division.
What's your message to people in the community who woke up this morning to find out about this mass shooting and then also found out about incidents that happened in other places across the country, too? What do you want them to hear from you?
Well, this is very disturbing. It's very disturbing what we're seeing across the country and the level of gun violence that we're seeing across the country. It's disturbing. And it's senseless. And I can tell you that we are fully committed here in the city of Savannah to addressing it and doing what we need to do to continue to stay on top of this. But it's very disturbing, especially when you see incidents like this that occur and the number of victims who are injured, and especially when you're talking about an infant child.
You said that.
If they're not there now, I believe they should be on the way. They had a pretty long night, so we wanted to allow them to at least get a little rest, refresh, and then get back over to the hospital.
Can you talk a little bit about priority level of a case of a shooting of this size and kind of what the resources look like and kind of the timeline for you guys moving forward?
Well, any shooting is a high priority for us because it presents a danger to the community, to the entire community. But I think you can take a look at the amount of resources that we had out there. It was a pretty chaotic scene, not just at the hospital, but also at the crime scene. It was a very dynamic scene, a lot of moving pieces at both scenes, and that's the reason why I say I really thank our fellow law enforcement partners for being available and assisting us with last night's investigation.
Can you say what hospital the victims were taken to?
Memorial Hospital. Yeah, prior to this incident, and this includes the homicide that happened early Friday morning, that was our 13th homicide. The one last night makes our 14th homicide
of this year.
Have
you brought anyone in for questioning?
Not at this time.
Are you guys working on leads at this point? I mean, do you have suspects in mind? Kind of what does that look like?
Well, and that's the part we're looking to get some assistance from the community on. We have very limited information that we're working with right now, and we're going to see what we can get from the follow-up investigation or follow-up interviews at the hospital, but that's the reason why we're making a strong plea to members of our community. We're pretty sure someone over in that neighborhood saw something or may have some information that they can bring forward, and that's the reason why we're really stressing. If you saw something, please say something. Please let us know. We want to make sure that this incident doesn't continue or something like this doesn't continue to occur in our community, and we definitely don't want to see anyone, especially a small child, injured again in our community.
And just to clarify,
out as no threat to the surrounding community, the public, if this was an isolated incident?
Well, we believe it is. I mean, but we're not sure right now. We still don't have any identified suspects. We still don't have a lot of information to follow up on. So we still have to be careful in terms of who we're looking for and what may have been the kind of the catalyst behind this incident.
Chief, you know what the sequence of events looked like last night and how exactly two children were caught in the middle of this gunfire?
Well, I do, but that's part of the investigation, so we don't want to reveal too much right now.
Was this like a party or a large gathering where people were together?
It's my understanding from the preliminary information that we have is that there were a few people who were standing in front of that residence, and there was a vehicle, the dark colored or possibly red sedan, that rolled by and fired rounds into that crowd.
Can you talk a little bit more specific about the Avery shooting on Tuesday, and how do you guys believe that is a direct connection, that this is stemming from that shooting specifically?
Well, we don't know. I don't think it was a coincidence that that particular residence was targeted on Tuesday and that particular residence was targeted again on Friday.
So as of right now, there seem as two separate events and you still have to do an investigation to find out whether
or not related.
Correct. So are you worried that, you know, another event would happen again? Are you providing more, I guess, coverage over there in that area in terms of public safety?
Absolutely. We're going to have an enhanced presence, not just in that area, but we'll have an enhanced presence throughout the city the remainder of this weekend. And that enhanced presence includes the police chief being out there.
And you said that you think it's, maybe odd that there's no witnesses coming forward and people are saying that they don't know what happened. Why do you think that there's this almost, like no one's coming forward and no one wants to help in the investigation in this particular neighborhood?
Well, first let me clarify, I don't think it's odd. To me, it's disappointing. It's disappointing. I don't know why people are not willing to come forward. Like I said, if they don't want to bring the information forward to us, there are other avenues that they can use where they can get the information to other individuals who can bring that information forward to us. We have gone to great lengths to make sure we provide as many avenues as possible for individuals to provide information to us. We just ask that they bring the information to us. I would have hoped that if someone would have brought that information to us earlier in the week, maybe we would have been able to identify some individuals, and maybe that would have led to a different conclusion than what we had last night.
You said the state of the hospital last night was chaotic, I think is the word you used. Did you go to the hospital, or are you able to describe a little bit of what happened there?
Well, I think when you look at the fact that we had 8 gunshot wound victims at the hospital, and we had family members for 8 gunshot wound victims showing up at the hospital. That provided a pretty tense situation and a pretty chaotic situation there. I'll do one more question.
And you said that they saw a dark colored or red sedan fleeing the area. Was this a drive-by shooting, or was someone physically outside shooting and then fled the scene in a dark sedan?
At this point, we do not believe, based on the preliminary information we have, that anyone exited that vehicle. All right. Thanks, folks. Appreciate all you coming, especially on such short notice. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Good job.
Good job.